So, I mean, you could see here if you cascade over this way with the camera. Well, you walk in. You can see we've got a bunch of, like, this is a lot of the old equipment that's abandoned as part of the quarrying operation, which is slowly winding down. The quarry is near the end of its natural life that the Scots ran for many years here in the Brac. Mm-hmm. And as part of the end of that journey, you could see them ferrying, as they ferry the fill from the quarry across this land to the loading dock that loads at the sea. As this ends its natural life and cycle, my thought is, I love the Brac. I've been coming over here with my son for, nearly a decade, actually over a decade, at the weekend, and we like it. It feels just soulful and good and underappreciated, and we'd like to try to enhance it, I guess at the pace that the community will accept it, and turn it into what you're standing in, whether you know it or not, is a small village that will eventually cascade down this hill, down this rambling hill, towards the water. In the distance, or we'll in the future have a small inlet and marina, and the ability to bring in, boats and fishing boats, and have the ability to have fresh food here, which is really what's lacking in the Brac. The problem here is that there's just not enough food infrastructure. Is really what's missing. What we take for granted in Grand Cayman with large-scale refrigerated storage and large-scale airside, the ability to move cargo aircraft in, the ability to bring seaport activity, like a cargo commercial activity, to bring in shelter into a sheltered harbor, the ability to bring in food and the necessities of life, that's more easily obtained in Grand Cayman than it is here in the Brac. Here it's a little bit more, it's a little bit more subsistence. It's a little bit more hard scrabble, in the sense that there just isn't enough infrastructure. And it's a chicken egg thing. There aren't enough people here with 1,500 people to activate the economy to justify bringing in food. But nobody is, no people are coming here. Few people want to stay and raise families and expand here from here because there's no food.
So do you see an expanding population in the Brac over the coming years?
I do. We have, let's put this in perspective, we have 1,500 people in the Brac, I think. And many are of retirement age, and there's some children here as well. So in terms of a workforce here, there may be, 1,000 people working and contributing to the economy of the Brac. And that supports Little Cayman as well, where there are just 300 people. So do I see that growing? Yes, but I think it's more likely that Little Cayman will wind up sheltered and protected as more like a UNESCO site of some kind. But to achieve that, you're gonna have to have a support post, as it were, and that I see the Brac filling that role. But right now there is no safe harbor whatsoever on the Sister Islands. Like, there's no shelter from rough weather. We saw that water spout when we flew in, and we're getting that time of year where you get large wave action. You have no shelter from that weather here, and there's really no viable port or no harbor facility. And what we hope to do is try to help create that by sacrificing or giving away this land that we purchased, really, to the sea, creating an inland waterway to allow for vessels to shelter from weather, right? To allow a small fishing fleet. If you go to Greece or you go to Italy and you see small little safe harbors that dot the coastline that provide shelter for a fishing boat, what do you get? You get high quality food, because now you can have 20, 30 fishing boats that go to the sea. And those fishermen can come back in and know that their investment, their family treasury in their boat is safe, at night.
So what
you
sort
don't have
of
that here.
Scale are you talking here? What kind of size of harbor and marina and excavation would it take?
It'll take probably 400,000 cubic yards of earth that we'll have to move out of the ground to create the equivalent of about 6 acres of protected water, right? Sheltered water, both protected from the sea by a finger going out, and protected inland so that you can have boats park, and come in safely from weather.